and also with you.
Welcome to our Mass this morning. To those who have joined us virtually, this service is being live streamed. To ensure it meets with government regulations and with no congregation present. Those that are in attendance are here to fulfill a role and are COVID safe. We come together today in the presence of God as we celebrate Remembrance Sunday. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. And so, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us begin by calling to mind our sickness.
Shows herself to them as they go, in every thought of theirs, coming to meet them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, "For you my soul is thirsty, O God, my God."
For you my soul is thirsty, O God, my God.
O God, you are my God, for you I long. For you my soul is thirsty, my body pines for you like a dry, weary land without water.
For you my soul is thirsty, O God, my God.
So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory. For your love is better than life, my lips will speak your praise.
For, for For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
On my bed I remember you. On you I muse through the night. You have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
The second reading, a letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Stay awake and stand ready, because you do not know the hour when the Son of Man is coming.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told this parable to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, 5 were sensible. The foolish ones did take their lamps, but they brought no oil, whereas the sensible ones took flasks of oil as well as their lamps. The bridegroom was late, and they all grew drowsy and fell asleep. But at midnight there was a cry. The bridegroom is here, go out and meet him. At this, all those bridesmaids woke up and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish ones said to the sensible ones, give us some of your oil, our lamps are going out. But they replied, there may not be enough for us and for you. You had better go to those who sell it and buy some for yourselves. They got off to buy it and the bridegroom arrived. Those who were ready went in with him to the wedding hall, and the door was closed. The other bridesmaids arrived later. Lord, Lord, they said, open the door for us. But he replied, I tell you solemnly, I do not know. So, stay awake, because you do not know either the day or the hour. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, in talking with some men who spoke a bit about their experiences during food that they had to eat, and how it was different from what the Americans had, and about a practical joke that had been pulled on a colleague. Aside from these things, though, little was said about the war. What they really remembered best, they did not speak of. It's really hard to talk about the details of what happened, to talk about the real costs, how your friends died, how your parents, your brothers or sisters paid the costs of war, and how your own minds and hearts were affected and never again quite the same. Our most important memories, for the most part, are silent ones, ones that we don't talk about because of the pain in them, and because they are almost impossible to share with anyone who has not been there with you. But it is important that we, who were not there, understand just what was done to us. It's important, too, that those who were there, those who fought and those who served here, while friends died across the seas, feel that all that happened was worth it, that it made a difference, and that those who were sacrificed, and sacrificed so much, are honored and rewarded. It is ever the same that in times of peace, soldiers, sailors, and airmen are not well appreciated. These days, we have no idea just what it was like all those years ago. But we do know what happened. We realize that a great tyranny was ended. That as the book of Revelation puts it, the time for destroying those who destroyed the earth had come. We know that there was a great cost. And so we honor today those who served and those who died, for us and for the country we live in. The scriptures call us all to look at the examples of the faithful, to honor them by remembering them and what they did, and to be more like them, to keep faith with them, and to hold high the torch they carry. The gospel today reminds us of how we must always be prepared. We must always preserve our faith and be faithful. We must always develop our faith, allow it to grow, develop and change us. Faith is alive and dynamic and will be able to support us in any time of need. And so today, as we remember so many people who have died in war, we can see even more clearly how much it matters to have faith that can support us, that can be real, even amidst extreme challenge and pain. Let us pray that our dead will continue to be honored, and that we and all people may be able to hold high the torch that they can no longer carry. Remembrance Sunday is not just a time to fast and mourn. It is not a time just to remember those who died. Still less is it a time to say that war is good or honorable. Rather, it is a time when we, as we recall those who gave themselves to us, remember just why it is they did what they did. A time to remember the horror of war and vow to ourselves, never again. A time to take up the torch once more and to dedicate ourselves anew to living in such a way that we do not break faith with those who died to bring peace to the world. A time to commit ourselves once again to the struggle against evil, the struggle against the very things that lead to war in the first place. And these are the things that Remembrance Sunday asks us to call to mind each year as we recall those who died, so that we may be free. So, let us pray that we will take up the torch and live in the way that God meant us to live.
one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, from being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict, and ask that God may give us peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Service men and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known by God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who left them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give them peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, call into mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
All who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray today for all those in this parish in which we live, especially all those affected by war. We pray that this church may soon open to public worship so that it may be, as its purpose, as a beacon of hope and of God's love to all those in this parish. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are sick or are suffering from any kind of need. We especially remember all those suffering from COVID-19 or from the mental health impact of lockdown. And we remember all those who we pray for day by day
let light perpetual shine upon them.
May they rest in peace
and rise in glory.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We join our prayers with those of Saint Michael and with all the saints, especially with those of Mary our mother, as together we say.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Thank you.
perpetual shine upon them.
May they rest in peace
and rise in glory.
Amen. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a virtual sign of that peace from wherever we are.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Thank you.
in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from everything. Graciously grant peace in our lives, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The kingdom,
the power,
and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen. I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
church will be open for private prayer, where there will be exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. We now stand and sing our national
also with you.
The Lord bless you and watch over you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look kindly upon you and give you peace. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you all and remain with you always. Go forth, the Mass is in you.
Thanks be to God.
Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.